I just learned the coolest thing, how to create custom graphics and blog articles for your website instantly. Let me show you my screen. We're gonna be using a program called Zapier, which connects programs together that don't normally communicate, and it's un-freaking believable. So the first step in this process is either you, your teammate, maybe someone you're trying to connect with, network with, is gonna fill out a Google form. It could be a Google form, it can be any sort of form, survey, poll. The data that you get in is gonna be used to be inserted into OpenAI's DALLE 3 and ChatGPT, and you're gonna generate text from those answers. That text is automatically gonna be uploaded into WordPress. You could even automatically set this up to a Gmail. You could automatically set this up to your CRM. There's a lot of cool things you could do, but I'm just gonna walk you through how to create the WordPress blog article. Okay, and one of the best ways to use this technology is as a networking tool. You know, so for example, you could create a form with various questions, go to LinkedIn and just ask CEOs, CMOs, CFOs, interesting people to fill out the form and say, hey, look, after you fill out the form, I'm gonna set you up on your own blog article and we're gonna highlight you. And that's kind of what this is designed to do here. So first thing we're gonna do is we connect our Google form. And on the Google form, you're going to ask it a number of questions. We've selected our form here already. And so a bunch of questions, you know, some of the questions that I ask in this form is, you know, what I'm trying to do with this form is highlight podcasters, highlight business owners that have podcasts. You might have a different idea for your form. That's fine. Just think about it in your term. So anyway, the questions I'm asking is, what's the name of your podcast? What are the links to your social media profiles? How has podcasting impacted your life? What's the name of your business? What do you do? What's the challenge you have in podcast? Again, you could ask all sorts of questions. It could be, what kind of company you run? What's your annual revenue? How many employees do you, how do you hire? You know, how are you leveraging outsourcing and AI? You could ask any sorts of questions to be populated into your blog. Okay, so after you've got the questions and answers, and after people have started filling it out, well, then we're going to go over, we're going to connect OpenAI's GPT-3 DALLE 3. And once you've connected that, you need to generate your action. And the magic is in the prompts. This was done pretty quickly in a demo I do in a mastermind group. If you ever thought about joining a mastermind, learn how to do this stuff, I'll put a link below. You can check that out. And in this prompt, what I'm saying is generate a vibrant creative image for WordPress banner based on the answer to the following questions. Do not include any letters or words. I find that when AI is generating words and letters, it often seems kind of weird. So I try to avoid that. Sometimes it's not going to cooperate and it might give that to you, but regardless, that's something to think about. We're doing standard quality. We're using the size dimension here of 1792 by 1024. This is going to give us a widescreen, you know, because we're going to be using this as the banner for our blog article. So we want it to be widescreen. So let's go ahead and continue. And next, we need to write the blog article itself. I don't want to write the blog article. Do you want to write the blog article? No, you don't. So we're going to have ChatGPT write the damn thing for us. So we connect our ChatGPT account. You know, let's walk through this here. So how am I prompting? I'm saying, hey, please write a 750 to 1,000 word blog article with title and headers for responses to the completed forms. The blog must be written in HTML format. This is important. You need to ask it to write it in HTML format. If it doesn't write it in HTML format, it's not going to properly create H1, H2 headers, titles. If you don't know what that means, that's fine. Just ask it to write it in HTML format. That's very important. We're going to optimize for SEO, and we want to add a custom image to the banner. Now, the image that we've selected here is the same image that was generated with DALLE. And if you're like, Mark, I don't understand what you're saying. You're speaking a different language. That's okay. Stay with me here. We're simply going to go in here, and we're going to have this little drop down, and you could either populate this with responses from Google Forms. We're going to select the generate image, and we're going to select this URL from the image that was generated. This is the image that was generated from DALLE, okay? That's how that works. The goal of the blog article is to highlight the business leader that completes the form. The blog article must be written in at least 750 words. The following information is what you need to complete the article. And here's all the answers to the blog questions that they've answered, okay? So let's go down here and just kind of select the mode. So you're going to want to select probably the newest model, the newest mode available. In our case, we're using Chat GPT 4. You could select any of these, but I would select Chat GPT 4 at least. Memory key, we're going to leave that blank, but maybe if there's stuff that you want included in all of your previous messages, you can include that. Again, I want to kind of move through this pretty quickly because your time is valuable. And by the way, thanks for smashing like and subscribe. Leave a comment below or a question below if you're a little bit lost, you need some help. I'm happy to help you with that. That's my way of saying thank you for watching the video. Okay. Anyway, assistants, you're an expert blog writer, focused on SEO and keywords. You write blog articles with at minimum 750 words. And the reason I keep repeating that is I found it very difficult to get ChatGPT to write that many words. It tends to want to write blog articles around the 300 to 400 word mark. We don't want that. We want at least 600 to 750 words in our blog article. At the end of the day, what you're probably going to do after this is populated is hire someone to go in and add some additional text. You might add some additional text. There's some things that you can do, but I at least want to give you the tools to be dangerous here. Max tokens, I've chosen 4,000. You are likely not going to need 4,000 tokens to do this. I'm just using 4,000 because I don't want to get cut off. So at any rate, you could choose something probably around the 2,000 token mark. Temperature. So what temperature means is how much you want ChatGPT to be creative. I choose 0.4, which is on the lower side. I want to be on the lower side because I don't want ChatGPT to get too crazy. I want it to follow my instructions and my directions. But you know what? For this example, I'm going to bump it up to 0.7 because I just kind of like playing with this stuff. It's super cool. So let's go ahead and refresh our fields. Continue, and we are going to test the step B because we want to update it with new information. As you can see, every time that you update any of the data inside here, you're going to want to make sure that you retest it. Every time you go through, you need to retest it until you find what I would call the secret sauce, that perfect match. And by the way, you know, I know I'm giving you a lot of stuff to do, but if you enjoy this stuff, if you want to be part of the anti-woke AI movement, go to aiupdate.ai. I have a free guide for you. It's 100 pages of ChatGPT strategy for your business. You need to know this stuff. So go ahead and get the guide at aiupdate.ai. Promise you none of that woke garbage. I don't like it. I won't give it to you. So go to the only anti-woke AI newsletter at aiupdate.ai. Now that we've updated our text in ChatGPT, we want to go ahead and connect it to our WordPress website. We are going to select Create a Post, continue. And what we're going to do here is give it a title. You know, there's different things you can do here. I'm going with the first name, last name, and what the name of the podcast is. Again, you could get creative here, but that's how I've set it up. Content, we're going to go in here and we're going to select the reply from what ChatGPT just wrote. Again, when you click in here, you'll see the summarized text in ChatGPT. And what we are doing is we're going to select the supply. You're going to see it's in HTML format. That's very important. You've already done that because you've been listening, you've been paying attention, and you hit the like button. That is very, very important for obvious reasons. Excerpt, I'm going to go ahead and choose as the excerpt, I'm going to choose the bio here. And what the excerpt is, that's something that's going to populate in Google or in search when people go ahead and search for this. So we are going to search for short bio as the excerpt. You could choose author. The rest of this stuff is not super relevant here. I'm going to kind of skip through it because I really want you to see the final product here. So we're going to refresh our fields. We're going to continue. And we are going to test the step. Can you feel the angst, the anxiety, the incoming blog article? I think that you can. And then lastly, I like to archive this in Google. You don't need to do that in Google Docs. I could also set it up to forward this to the, via Gmail to the person that filled out the form. There's all sorts of stuff you could do here. In my case, we're just going to stop it here because this is where we're at right now. Okay, so let's go over here to WordPress. So let's go over to WordPress and let's see what we've got. Let's see what we have filled out. So here is the WordPress blog article. It's already been written for us. Let's go ahead and check it out. So we can see here, it just shocks me every single time. It is automatically created the image in DALL-E. It's automatically uploaded it to our WordPress blog. Look how sick that is. Now, because we've asked it to HTML code it, all of our links are blue, they're underlined, they're hyperlinked right there. It's categorized our title, it's added our title. It's also given us an H1 heading. It's formatted our H2 headings, our H1 headings. That is absolutely amazing. I am just blown away every time I see this. Now, one of the things that we'll point out here, and again, this is a struggle, it's only 308 words long. So what you might want to do is hire someone like an agency like Ion. You might want to hire a VA, or you might want to spend just a couple minutes kind of go in here and add a few additional words. I think that's also important when it comes to ranking. If you're just copy and pasting ChatGPT into Google, that there are beliefs that it could hurt your ranking. I don't know. I heard Neil Patel, one of the best SEO experts in the world. He was on my podcast. He said, I think we should be using it. At the end of the day, though, we want it to be readable. So you probably want to take 3 minutes on the back end and kind of fill this out. The other thing that's important here is you're going to want to add your focus keyword. For this type of project where I'm highlighting specific individuals, I'm going to use the keyword of the guest himself, the person that we're featuring here, in my case, Mark Savant. Hit enter, boom. I haven't touched anything. I kind of cleaned up the formatting a little bit. All I did was add a focus keyword. All of a sudden, this is ranked in the green, 81 out of 100 for SEO. Now you've created an SEO-rich blog article. You could do this at scale. I could start to send this form out to everybody I know on LinkedIn. I could start a huge marketing campaign, which is unbelievable. If you're interested in learning more about how to do this, you can certainly leave a comment below. I want to see you successful with AI. I want to see you crush it, because we need a woke-free world, baby. We need a world where people are creating sick-ass content, growing their own business, leading others, and keeping it woke free. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, thanks for smashing subscribe and like. I'll catch you in the next video. All right? Peace.